Fashion.
Hey, it's your girl Shana Maina, and this is the Mouth of the South show. I have a special guest. We don't play games over here. We should disconnect his controller
because he doesn't even. Man, she already trying to get my sponsors out the window.
He doesn't even call y'all, tell, check on my friend like that.
It's not like that, okay? You know, like a black man in the process of doing the right thing.
He become famous, y'all. He gonna act the same way, and I'm barely gonna see my friends. So it's like you need to start practicing that now. I'm just kidding. But this has been my good friend for a while. iGameBoi. Mm-hmm. It's been hard to get him.
I'm very proud of her. She is just doing it. Y'all should stay tuned with her.
I appreciate it. How is the process going?
It's going great. You know, I just got in contact with the producer. On the track or whatever it is. I'm pretty sure most of you guys know I'm filming the swag surfing type song back in the day. But I did my last project, I did a song with a couple of his tracks or whatever it is. It's doing great since then. And ever since, I've been doing more tracks with him. And shout out to DJ Flip as well, you know, because he's a part of the process as well. Got me going along with the 808 cartel and beats and everything. Everybody doesn't really need to know everything that's just enough or whatever. So as a person like myself, life, I try to keep going forward. That's all. Don't look back, just keep going forward. If you look back, you're gonna be here forever.
So. Right. So how did you get started? How did iGameBoi become this person?
Just to keep it short. Back when I was in middle school, how I got the name actually, it was before that. Not loud, but my name was anything. It was Y Ism. I don't know why I get that. But that was the name. And then for a minute I was going for that. And then I get like a little play in middle school. And a lot of girls used to always say you play a lot of games, boy. So I kinda took that to heart and I was like, game boy, because I played a lot of video games. I have Sega Genesis all the way up to the current game system right now. I'm a gamer like a mofo. I have a Twitch on here. Just being honest. But how can I say it? Long story short again, my cousin, she was making pictures on MySpace, I think, back in the day. And when I changed my name from Y to Game Boy, my dad told me, well, you know, Game Boy, Nintendo will sue you. So I took off the, what was it? I took off the Y, just put I, and it was just Game Boy. And then one time she made me a flyer. Soldier Boy at the time, and he had an album called I Soldier Boy Tell Him. And again, I ain't gonna lie, Soldier Boy is one of the few artists I look up to. Not, well, I ain't gonna say music wise, but business wise, the guy's a genius. I can't say that. And how can I say this? She made a flyer and it just said iGameBoi, and it was all together. And after that, I just really ran with it, and nobody really had no complaints since then. And ever since then, the name just kind of stuck out. And a lot of folks were just like, iGameBoi, that's kind of a weird name. For a person that look like you all the time, you see that. But for a person that look like you, it's a weird name. And I can stand by it. If you ask me anything about any video game, I can probably tell you about it. It's nerdish, I know. But it's me. That's how I got the name.
So iGameBoi is a rapper. He's also a producer. So what do you like the most? Do you like rapping, producing? What's your favorite?
Subject is always going to be two of us, history and literature, always. I love science and stuff, but history and literature, that's what makes rapping so easy to me. I can really go anywhere from toe to toe with that. When it comes to producing, it's a special feeling when you get behind the board and you know, you're playing those keys. And since I'm an artist myself, I know exactly how to sync up at the right time, how to break down and go, how to say this. And we all did this before, especially if you're a producer. Like, yeah, man, you know, if Wayne got sad, and I still have a deuce, but if tomorrow somebody cut off my hands, that's a different story. So, yeah, I'm pretty sure you can tell probably. You know what, I'm just going to say producer. I'm going to say producer. Yeah, producer. I'm going to say that. It's kinda, I want to say it's hard to explain, but I'm going to produce. I don't know what it is, but I'm going to go ahead.
So let's talk about your projects. What have you produced? Let's start there first.
As far as other artists and myself, it's been a while since I produced for other artists because I've been in the cave for so long, in the studio, locked in, years and years or whatever, mainly because of certain situations I haven't reached out to nobody like that. A few artists I have reached out to. If any of you know my music, you know, you wouldn't know, like I said, I don't really see no names because some of the people I deal with just know I don't see no names. Anyway, so for myself, a lot of my projects, you know, but the last, probably, the last track I produced for myself exactly, probably like a year and a half ago. I still produce, but probably like a year and a half ago because, what was it? A friend of mine, I call him brother, of course, Free J Flame, my little bro, he had told me one day, he was like, now I know you like producing, you produce as well. But he was like, why don't you try going ahead, you know, you got like another, you know, another flavor, another style, other producing music. And that's what I did. And ever since then, I'm getting in the, you know, field of a lot of other producers. And I'm kind of glad I've been doing it because I've been meeting a lot of great people, a lot, from females to males to even people you wouldn't even think that's old enough to do it, but they meet a lot of producers. So, project-wise, kind of stuck right now. You know, I mean, don't get me wrong, like I just dropped one last year, Key 5. Sorry, you got this. Key 5 or whatever the heck. And this year, I should be coming out with Handheld 2, but I cannot really tell you the process of how anything will want to go, because it's kind of sort of all over the place, because one minute I'm in Atlanta, and one minute I'm down here. I'm not gonna lie, one minute I'm in my own at-home studio, and how can I say, if anybody's an artist out there, you know for a fact when it comes to tracking your own, you know, list or whatever for your album mixtape, it's kind of hard, because you'll feel like, this is it, and this is it, and this is it, and this is that. It's, my headspace right now is like, I probably like a punk with you from the last couple of months that I met you. I mean, single artists I met you, so last time I seen you, I probably had like 70 some songs that I have not used at all. So I have a lot of music, but I don't know exactly which ones to put there. It's kind of hard right now. But I'm not going to say I'm scared, but I just want this one to be, you know, one of the ones like, oh, okay, yeah, he's out there. Like, you know, he has something to say, you know, he has something to, you know, talk about. And, you know, no disrespect to anybody else out there, but, you know, he has something different. He sounds different than anybody else. Because like T-Pain said, we already have a little baby and a little Dirk and everything else. So I'm not trying to be that guy. That sounds like everybody and their mama up the street. Just being honest. Just saying. Just saying.
So I know you have worked with a lot of good people in the industry. What's some good advice have they given to you?
I'm going to say the best one, God bless the dead, was Bankroll Fresh. I didn't necessarily really get to meet him, like, I can say I met him, but not meet him as like a studio or whatever the heck. I met him in the mall, and I let him hear my beats on the phone or whatever the heck, and the same year he passed away. Ironically, I came back home from college because my college was getting shut down by the feds, long story short, I mean, tell that. But how can I say this? When I met him, he was like, man, I love your beats and everything. And I told him my cousin, if y'all don't know, TK Kravitz, Kravitz Gang, you know, it's my older cousin. My bow. But he was like, oh, it's your cousin. At the time, he was the group TK and Cash. And they came out with a song. I mean, that's on the mixtape, No Handouts. And Fresh was on the mixtape. And ironically, like I said, I ran into him and I told him all this and that, and he was like, you know what, man, I like the tracks, you know what I'm saying? Keep going, what else he said? He was like, just keep going, what he said, I'm not trying to say it in the most fucked up way or whatever the heck, because it was street nigga shit, but he said, just fuck them niggas and keep going over the hill, you know? I mean, that's the best way I can put it, because there's a lot going on. I'm not going to say he sat right there and talked to me, he was walking by and stuff like that, but out of all people that I met, shit raw. I like that, man. You know what I'm saying? Shit's different, man. Keep going with it. Before them niggas won't don't let nobody tell you can't do this shit, man. You know what I'm saying? Keep going with it. Gain my number and everything, you know, and that same year I came back home. I'm not gonna say that same month, but later on that year, I came back home, found out, you know, her man was murdered and everything. Don't get me wrong, man, you know, things happen, what type of lifestyle you're living, so, you know, that comes with territory and stuff like that. But those few words, you know what I'm saying, compared to other people that I'm not gonna mention, because out of respect of a few people I know as well, but he was the only one out of those couple of seconds that made everything feel like it mattered. So, I'm going to say him, Bankroll Fresh, R.P. that guy, man, literally. And I was a teenager, man, that I ain't gonna lie, I was starstruck. Yeah, I'm not afraid to admit that, man, I was starstruck, man. I did not think I was going to run into, you know, one of the hottest rappers at the time, you know, in the mall, in Atlanta, like that. I mean, in Atlanta, of course, but not like, I like that, where everybody was just in there. And like, to be honest with you, the way he had the credibility there, it was like when he was walking in there, like he was home. Like, I mean, everybody knew he was in there, but he was like, what's up, man? Blah, blah, blah. You know, he was loving everything. So, again, that's one of the things. I looked at him like, hey, you know, he still got killed in his home city. So, still kind of fucks with me a little bit because I'm always home. And I know a couple of other artists that's out here doing it the same way. I want y'all to be careful out here, man. Can't that nigga out here tell you, you know what I'm saying, who you can or can't be. You know, if a nigga press you a certain way, man, you know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna say let that shit go, you know what I'm saying? Cause it's spilling blood, but like, get your money, man. Just get the fuck on, man. Just move forward.
Stop hating on other people.
That shit ain't worth it.
Let them live.
You know, people got kids and family and shit. Like, how y'all do, man? But try to find another way to eat. It's 2022, man. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of ways to do this shit, man. I'm pretty sure money, man, tell y'all to do something.
What do you have coming up to your project?
Project, like I said, Hand Held 2. That's my product I'm going to focus on right now because I got a lot of invested to, like, as far as not just money, but like time and effort. A lot of family drama, stuff like that. Just a whole bunch of business, and, you know. And like, I had to talk to, I'm going to get real personal. Two things. I haven't talked to my mom in years. It's been like so long since I talked to her. So it's one of those situations where, you know, I again put my heart and soul into, you know, this music. Like I said, not necessarily get too personal, but for people to understand where I'm coming from. Because her, you know, even though my grandparents were real, I love my mother. Y'all, I'm pretty sure y'all ain't gonna see this, but I will show it, you know. Just saying. But, you know, she's still my mom and everything. You know, she everything she could. So this project is kind of, you know, going to lean a little bit of towards a more painful, I guess, but not as in like in a gimmick way. I mean, we singing and that shit, man, but y'all here, man. My bro, you know, he locked up. He ain't going to explain too much of what, you know, what he got going on, but just know, you know, he's been in there for a minute, and, you know, he been watching the moves and stuff. That's my little bro, you know. I'm gonna say he's more gangster than me. Way more gangster, man. He doing some serious shit. And you know, until he come back home and a couple of other things, you know, get the crack and the shake, and then he just get too much on it. But, you know, can't wait till he go home and make sure I do what I gotta do. Everybody. For the project.
Are you a freestylist person?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, how can I be a fan of Lil Wayne? I'll be a freestyler.
Ha ha!
this, press the button again, every play this, we trying to get money. My sister though, niggas don't understand, we trying to really get butterfly doves. I don't fuck with people, and I don't fuck with hoes. They ain't trying to get money like that, so niggas gotta go. I stack this shit, nigga, like it was Lego, but these niggas don't know these hoes won't let go like it was Ego. I can't fuck with none of these hoes, like I said before, because a nigga like me gotta stand on my 10 toes, set a nigga up. Nah, that ain't me though, I get this shit. Niggas mad at me because I make this shit flip real quick, can't understand how you feel. Now you ain't too real. These niggas mad at me because I ain't never got to pop no pill. I smoke that marijuana. Yeah, I smoke that gun shit. Got them niggas feeling weird. Nah, y'all niggas ain't my partners. Y'all niggas ain't like me. Y'all niggas can't be nowhere. Y'all can't be like me because I flex like Ric Flair. Y'all can't come nowhere near like we talking about. These niggas mad at me because I'm with the mob for the South. Bitch.
Bitch! You have a friend, man.
Oh, man, I love you too, dog, man.
Thank you for coming on the show.
Oh, anytime. I hope I missed it. Oh, no. Okay, cool. My sister kicked my ass this show. She was like,
they said she could do my lash if you want to.
She might be under the comments after this.
Okay. So, I'm going to have you to read You Are Magic
Board. Okay, cool. Let's do it.
Shoot some magic and be some good magic.
Oh, my God. She's one of the hottest. Hottest, nah, you are one of the hottest people doing this in the motherfucking South. We got to talk with the town, with the mouth of the motherfucking South.
The
baby.
Whole South.
You know what I'm saying?
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Anytime, man, anytime.
I love you.
Thank you. Too, though, man. I'm glad my people reached out to you. I was so surprised when they was like, yeah, you know this girl right here? Yeah, I know her, man. You bought them way to discover, man. I was like, what? Shit, we went in Atlanta. I was like, wow, man. Shana's really doing a damn thing.
In Atlanta?
Yes, man.
Really?
Yes. That's why I was sipping the internet. Shit, it's perfect. So perfect, man. You don't know who you got. You don't know who's looking at it. Literally, I ain't gonna lie. Now, my grandma was kind of scared to cook because she thought she was gonna ask me some derogatory questions. You know what I mean? She thought I was gonna share you when like, man, ain't nothing like that. Ain't nothing like that.
Like the will of mama, get on hard, tippy toes, and she